Hello everybody and welcome to Romancefull's Tarot. I'm about to begin here with the reading is a general reading, so it may not resonate with everybody. So please do take whatever resonates with you and just leave the rest aside. If ever you would like to have your own personal reading, please do contact me at romancefulltarot@gmail.com and it'll be my great pleasure to send you the different type of readings that that I can offer you so that we can find those answers that you are looking for. So may it be somebody that you're not trusting, may it be just somebody that you know you just don't have any answers whatsoever. So whatever the situation is, please do contact me and I'll be able to help you with that. So on another note, if you do enjoy the channel and you have not yet subscribed to the channel, please do take a brief moment to click on the subscribe button to show your support to the channel and to myself, and it is always greatly appreciated. So with no further ado, we're going to begin this reading here. This reading is a reading, as I said, it is for the sign of Virgo. It is a general reading, but what we want to know here is, what is the future of your relationship? So we want to know, is this going to be a yes? Is it going to be a no? Is it going to be a maybe? What is going to be going on? So I'm using four different decks. I have the Angel Answers. I have the Romance Angels. I have the Lover's Oracle. And I have the Work Your Light. So let's go and see what kind of information I can get for you with all of these. So I have four of the Lover's Oracles. Now, the first answer is, you know what? Only time is going to tell. And then we have, let there be closeness between you, but always give each other space. Love never claims, it simply allows and gives, which is absolutely beautiful, absolutely true. I could not even, you know, that is just it. So this is really about, you know, love is never going to ask you anything, you know, that is not of you, that is not natural of you, that you're not comfortable with. So, you know, it just allows and it gives, and that is it, and that is all, and that is the beauty of love. If it is more complex than that, oh, we need to be careful. Each and every relationship that is nice and long-lasting has a nice, fantastic baseline foundation of friendship. Friendship, nurture the bonds of friendship within your relationship and your love life will dramatically improve. If you just start your relationship off and there's only passion and it ignites, what happens? The flame dies. So you really need to have that friendship level. If you don't have it, then you need to work on it. And really fun to do is to just go out and do some fun things together and get to learn, you know, to know each other a little bit more, maybe with different type of activities. Even if you've been together for the longest of time, you do find things out. You do discover things, you know, about your partner. And not only that, but people change. So you change within the years. Maybe some things that you used to like, you don't like anymore. Maybe some things you're willing to try that you weren't willing to try into the past. So the same goes for the partner. So really important to have that basic friendship where, you know, where the only person that you can really trust into this world, if there's anybody you can trust, would be really nice to know that it's your partner. So that being said, I also have over here, beware though of what you are projecting for the qualities that you admire in one another are qualities that you both possess. So equally so, the qualities you don't like are also your own reflection. So be very, very careful. When sometimes we get upset at people because, you know, we don't really like what they did, or, you know, it reminds us of, yes, it reminds us of us. We just don't really want to admit it, but often they're doing things that just kind of bug us, but that's because it really bugs us within us. So let's just be careful about that. It's really just not even important. It's just little arguments that, you know, end up to absolutely nothing. So let's just accept each other however you are. And if you can accept your partner as they are, then you should not be into that relationship with that partner. So let's not try to modify anybody. Everybody who is who they are. If your partner bugs you all, well, maybe you should not be with that partner, right? So Let's go see what the romance angels have to say, because over here I really have an unknown kind of zone, you know, with only time's going to tell. But we talk about closeness, we talk about friendship, we talk about accepting the other. Over here I have forgive and learning, so please, you need to release anything that is from the past. So any past relationships need to be gone, they need to be suppressed and, you know, just gotten rid of. You need to experience more love into your present moments right now. So maybe you need to spend more time with your partner, more quality time. So I don't know how you do spend your time, if it's sitting down watching TV or if it's actually, you know, sitting down and discussing over a glass of wine or going for a walk or whatever it is. Try and spend some more quality time with your partner. You'll see that it's really going to go a long way. And very important to leave the past behind, okay? Maybe the past in your present relationship, or maybe the past, from exes. You need to let that go, okay? The exes have nothing to do into this relationship. And your partner right now, if they did anything to bother you, to hurt you in any kind of emotional way, then you need to discuss it with them right away, so you can just let that go, so it doesn't keep following you over and over and over again with time. Give your relationship a chance, so please do work on that partnership, okay? You need to spend some time with your partner, you need to do some fun things, you need to accept them, you need to get that friendship into the relationship. It really is quite strong, and you need to make the effort. So you know what? Great love is worth taking the steps that you're guided to take. As for your relationship, the angel answers say, you know what? There's no need to worry. So stop worrying. Okay, and you need to remain positive. So if you want positivity, if you want great things to come towards you, yes, you have to work towards them, but you also have to ask up for the universe for whatever it is that you want. If you ask up for things, or if you never ask anybody and you don't really work on anything and you kind of stay negative, you're never going to go anywhere. You're just going to stay in that negativity. Nonetheless, if you're always negative, you're going to lose all the positive that you have in your life right now. So it's very important to try and remain positive. If anything ever happens to bother you, then you need to work on the working on, you know, getting rid of it. So your relationship is full of opportunity, okay? So don't let that opportunity go, okay? These are just like gold leaves that are being thrown up into the air. Don't let that go. Relationships are important. They need to be strong. They need to be nurtured. They need to be cared for. So be very, very careful, okay? We're going to move on to the final card of the reading, which is you're already doing it. So this is work your light, and it's stop overthinking and keep facing your true north. So do not question things so much. You're on the right track. You are facing the right way. So stop overthinking it. It's happening, and you are closer than you think. You are exactly where you need to be, and things are moving at the perfect speed. Do not rush it. Now is not the time to be impatient. Now is the time to walk steady. There is no rush, and what you are building is being built, and what you have planted soon is going to blossom. The friendship over here. With every new day, a new brick is being laid. You have come a long way. The foundations are steady. Now all that is needed is for you to trust and to keep walking forward. If a thought that things should be moving faster enters your head, that is just your ego that is comparing your rising to someone else. So comparison is not your friend. Stay in your lane, water your own garden, and knowing that your time to bloom is going to come soon. So this, my dear friends, is your reading. I do hope that you enjoyed it. I hope it resonated and made sense to you. Take whatever was good for you, leave the rest aside. If you would like a reading, romancefulltarot@gmail.com. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Stay tuned for any of the following readings that are going to be coming up. I put a new one out every day. And have a great day. Thank you so very much for being there, and I'll be seeing you soon.